Today, we shall discuss on module 2 of chapter 8. The title of chapter 8 is conjugate spaces. In module 1, we had discussed on some known spaces and their dual spaces. We had studied the properties of first dual, sometimes we call first conjugate spaces of some known spaces. So, in the study of first conjugate spaces, isometric isomorphism definitions and their properties are to be needed. Today, we shall discuss on second conjugate spaces, how the second conjugate spaces are constructed. If we take a nonlinear space X, we can construct its first conjugate space X dashed. Similarly, we can construct its second dual written as X double dashed, and continuing this in this way, we can construct so many conjugate spaces. So, with this, we are now going to start the properties of second conjugate spaces. Let us now start module 2 of chapter 8. The title of module 2 is second conjugate spaces. Now, let us take E be a nonlinear space and let F belongs to E star, where E star is the first conjugate space of E. That means, E star is the collection of all bounded linear functionals over E. It is to be noted that collection of all bounded linear functionals E star is always a Banach space with respect to operator norm. Denote E star whole star equal to E double star. Similarly, we get E triple star and so on. Let us take an element X belonging to E and it is fixed. And let F belongs to E star varies. Then we get a set of scalars Fx. For a fixed X belonging to capital E, define a map capital F X from E star to K, where K is the field of scalars by Fxf equal to Fx. It is easy to see that Fx is linear. That means, if we take f comma g belonging to E star, then f x f plus g equal to f x f plus f x g. For any scalar lambda, f x of lambda f equal to lambda of f x f. Also, f x is bounded. So, this can be seen from the following fact. Let us take F belonging to E star. Now, modulus of Fxf equal to mod Fx. As F belongs to E star, F is a bounded linear functional. So, we can apply modulus of Fx is less or equals to norm F into norm X. Thus, norm of Fx is less or equals to norm X. So, Fx belongs to E double star. Now, define a map C from E to E double star by Cx equal to Fx, where x belongs to capital E. Take x comma y belongs to capital E and alpha beta are any two scalars. Now, f alpha x plus beta y f equal to, by definition, f alpha x plus beta y. As f is linear, so f of alpha x plus beta y equal to alpha f x plus beta f y, which is equal to alpha f x f plus beta f y f, that equal to alpha f x plus beta f y of small f. This is true for all f belongs to E star. So, f alpha x plus beta y equal to alpha f x plus beta f y. Thus, C alpha x plus beta y equal to alpha C x plus beta C y. So, C is additive. Similarly, C of lambda x equal to lambda of C x. So, therefore, C is linear. Take x not equal to 0 vector belongs to capital E. So, by application of Hahn-Banach theorem, there exists a functional f
belonging to E star such that fx equal to norm x with norm of f is equal to 1. Now, fx belongs to E double star, already we have seen. So, norm of fx equal to supremum of modulus of fxf, where norm of f equal to 1 and supremum is taken over all elements f belongs to E star, which is again equals to supremum of modulus of fx, where norm of f equal to 1 and supremum is taken over all such elements f belongs to E star. Now, norm of x equal to modulus of fx, which is less or equals to, by the earlier relation, supremum of all such elements modulus of fx, where small norm f equal to 1 and supremum is taken over all such small elements f belongs to E star, which is equal to norm of fx. So, norm x less or equals to norm fx. Hence, by the above two relations, we get norm fx equal to norm x. Take x comma y belongs to capital E with x is different from y. Take f belongs to E star. Now, f of x minus y of small f equal to, by definition, f of x minus y, which is equal to norm x minus y. Also, f x minus y of small f equal to f x minus y, which is equal to f x minus f y, which is again equals to f x f minus f y f, which is equal to f x minus f y of small f. This is true for all f belongs to E star. Therefore, f x minus y equal to f x minus f y, that is capital F x minus y equal to capital F x minus capital F y. But norm capital F x minus y equal to norm x minus y. This implies norm capital F x minus capital F y equal to norm x minus y. Thus, F x not equal to F y. That is capital F x not equal to capital F y for x not equal to y. We have C x equal to capital F x. So, for x not equal to y, C x not equal to C y. Therefore, C is injective. Also, C is surjective. So, C is an isomorphism between E and the range of C. That is, C of capital E is a subset of E double star with the preservation of norm. If CE is equal to E double star, then we say that E is reflexive. In that case, we write E equal to E double star. As per examples, the nonlinear spaces Rn, the nonlinear spaces Cn, the nonlinear spaces Lp, where 1 less than p less than infinity, are reflexive Banach spaces. Because if we consider the nonlinear space Rn, then we have seen in module 1 its first conjugate space or its first dual is also Rn. If we take its another dual, that is, if we take the dual of Rn, then we again see the second dual is also Rn. So, Rn equal to Rn double star and Rn double star equals to Rn. Similarly, if we take the collection of all n tuples over the field of complex numbers, then we see that the first conjugate space of Cn is also Cn. Similarly, if we take another first conjugate of Cn, we get the second conjugate space of Cn. Thus, we see that the second conjugate space of Cn is also Cn. So, that is why Rn and Cn are reflexive. Now, for the nonlinear space Lp, where 1 less than p less than infinity, we have seen in module 1 the first conjugate space of LP is LQ, where 1 by P plus 1 by Q equal to 1. Again, if we take the first conjugate space of LQ, we again see the conjugate space of LQ is also LP by the relation 1 by P plus 1 by Q is equal to 1. So, we see that LP equal to LP double star. Hence, Rn, Cn, LP are all reflexive Banach spaces. The mapping C from E to E double star is called the canonical mapping of E into E double star. Now, let us take a theorem. Let x1, x2, dot, 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 xn be a set of n numbers of linearly independent vectors in capital E. Then there exist functionals x1 star, x2 star, dot, 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 xn star belonging to E star such that xj star xi is equal to 1 if I equal to j, xj star xi equal to 0 if I not equal to j. The proof looks like this. For j belongs to the set of elements 1, 2, dot, dot, n, consider a set capital Mj is equal to third bracket x1, comma x2, comma dot, 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 xj minus 1, comma xj plus 1, comma dot, 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 xn. That is the subspace generated by x1, x2, dot, dot, xj minus 1, comma xj plus 1, dot, dot, xn, excluding the elements xj. That means, Mj is a subspace generated by all elements x1, x2, xn, excluding the elements xj. So, dimension of Mj is strictly less than infinity, that is dimension of Mj is finite. Then for each capital Mj for j equal to 1, 2, dot, dot, n is closed. Now, xj does not belong to Mj by the construction of the subspace Mj. So, by applications of Hahn-Banach theorem, we get a functional fj belonging to E star such that fj xj equal to 1 and fj xi equal to 0 for I equal to 1, 2 up to j minus 1, comma j plus 1, comma dot, dot, dot up to n. Now, define a functional xj star equal to fj divided by fj xj for j equal to 1, 2 up to n. So, xj star belongs to E star for j equal to 1, 2 up to n. Now, xj star xj equal to fj xj divided by fj xj, which is equal to 1, and xj star xi equal to fj xi divided by fj xj, which is equal to 0 because we have taken fj xj equal to 0 for I equal to 1, 2 up to j minus 1, comma j plus 1, comma dot, 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 n. That means, xj star xi equal to 1, where I equal to j, and xj star xi equal to 0, where I not equal to j. Thus, we have got the required result.
Up to this, in this module, we have been introduced with the notion of second conjugate spaces. Also, we have learned what is second conjugate spaces, what is reflexive Banach spaces. Now, we shall study some properties on reflexivity of a nonlinear space.
We shall now study some additional properties of second conjugate spaces. Let us take a theorem. If dimension of E is equal to n, then dimension of E star is also equals to n. That is, if the dimension of a underlying space E is equal to n, then dimension of its first conjugate space E star is also equal to n. Let us take a proof. Let x1, x2, dot, 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 xn be a basis of capital E because dimension of E is equal to n is assumed. So, by earlier theorem, there exists a set of functionals x1 star, x2 star, dot 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 xn star belonging to E star such that xi star xj is equal to 1 if I equal to j is equal to 0 if I not equal to j. Now, let us take a set of scalars alpha 1, alpha 2, dot 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 alpha n belonging to k, where k being the field of scalars. Put alpha 1 x 1 star plus alpha 2 x 2 star plus dot 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 plus alpha n x n star is equal to theta, where theta being the 0 functional. Now, alpha 1 x 1 star plus alpha 2 x 2 star plus dot 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 alpha n x n star of x j is equal to 0 for j equal to 1 to up to n. This shows that alpha j is equal to 0 for all j equal to 1 to up to n. That means x 1 star, x 2 star, dot 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 x n star are linearly independent. Hence, dimension of E star is equal to n. Let us take another theorem. If dimension of E is finite, then x is reflexive. Let us take the proof. Let dimension of E is equal to n, say. So, by earlier theorem, dimension of E star is equal to n. That means, dimension of first conjugate space of E is equal to n. So, dimension of E double star is equal to n. That means, dimension of second dual of E is equal to n. Now, let us define a map C E to E double star defined by C x equal to x double star, where x belongs to capital E. The mapping C is called the canonical mapping. Now, x double star belongs to E double star is linear. Also, we have seen that C is 1 1 and onto and non-preserving. So, capital E is isometrically isomorphic to E double star. That is, CE is equal to E double star. Hence, E is reflexive. In this connection, we take a corollary. If E is reflexive, then E is complete. That means, if E is a nonlinear space, then its first conjugate space E star is complete. If we take its another dual, we see that E double star is again complete. As E is reflexive, so E equal to E double star. As E double star is complete, so E is complete. Let us take another theorem. If capital E is a separable reflexive Banach space, then E star is separable. Now, E is reflexive. So, E equal to E double star. As E is separable, so E double star is separable. That means, star of E star is separable. We know that if X star is separable, then X is separable. Here, star of E star is separable, so E star is separable, and this is the required result. Let us take another theorem. If capital E is a reflexive nonlinear space, then E star is reflexive. That means, if the underlying space capital E is a reflexive nonlinear space, then its first dual is also reflexive. Let us take a map. C star from E star to double star of E star is equal to star of E double star. Be a canonical map of E star onto star of E double star. We shall now show that C star is onto. Let us take star of X double star belongs to star of E double star. Define a functional X star on E by X star X equal to star of X double star of Cx, where X belongs to capital E and capital C is the canonical mapping of E onto E double star. Clearly, X star from capital E to capital K, where capital K being the field of scalars is linear and continuous and hence bounded. So, X star belongs to capital E star. Now, E is reflexive. So, for X double star belonging to capital E double star, there exists X belonging to capital E such that Cx equal to X double star. Now, C star of X star of X double star equal to X double star of X star, which is equal to Cx of X star, which is equal to X star of X, is equal to star of X double star of Cx, which is again equals to star of X double star of X double star. So, C star of X star acting on X double star equal to star of X double star acting on X double star. Hence, C star of X star is equal to star of X double star. That means C star is onto. So, X star is reflexive. We get another theorem. If capital E is a reflexive Banach space and capital Y be a closed subspace of E, then capital Y be reflexive. Let us take the proof. Let small y belongs to capital Y be fixed. Define a canonical map CY from capital Y to Y double star, which is an into mapping. We shall now show that CY is onto. Let Y double star belonging to capital Y double star. We now define X double star by letting X double star of X star equal to Y double star of X Y star, which is equal to Y double star of X star acting on capital Y for every X star belonging to capital X star. We see that X suffix capital Y star is the restriction of X star in capital Y. Since capital E is reflexive, so for every X double star belonging to E double star, there exists X belonging to capital E such that Cx equal to X double star. We shall now show that X belonging to capital Y. If not, that means if X is not an element of capital Y, by Hahn-Banach theorem, there exists an element X0 star belonging to E star such that X0 star X equal to 1 and X0 star X equal to 0 for all X belonging to capital Y, since capital Y is closed. Now, 1 equal to X0 star X, which is equal to X double star acting on X0 star, which is equal to Y double star acting on X0 capital Y star, which is equal to Y double star acting on X0 star upon capital Y, which is equal to Y double star of 0, which is equal to 0, but which is not possible. So, X belongs to capital Y. Thus, C suffix capital Y of X is equal to Y double star. That means CY is onto, hence capital Y is reflexive. Let us take a simple problem. If capital E is a Banach space and E star is reflexive, then capital E is reflexive. Now, E double star is reflexive, but E is a subset of E double star. Since E is a closed subset of E double star, it follows that capital E is reflexive.
Up to this, in this module 2 of chapter 8, we have been acquainted with some notion of conjugate spaces, second conjugate spaces. Also, we have learnt some basic properties on reflexivity of a nonlinear space. With this, we now come to an end of this module 2 of chapter 8.